Already know we got to discuss something involving Lonzo Ball, ZO2, the Chino Hills prodigy. We got some serious news to discuss. He is working out, continuing his workouts with Chris Johnson as he prepares for his epic comeback. Homage will be paid. All haters, all knees will bow. When Lonzo Ball touches that floor, you already know what it is. I'm telling you right now. He's doing all of the right things. We're going to discuss some things that's going on with Chicago, because Chicago seems like, it looks like Lonzo and the Bulls, they may be moving in two different directions. And sooner or later, in a couple of minutes, hours, days, we may be breaking some serious news here at Flight Sports. So make sure you buckle up. You don't touch that dial and hit the subscribe button, because we're going to be bringing an array of Lonzo Ball content as we patiently await his return. We've been waiting for years now. Now, as you can see, Lonzo told us in the podcast some of the things that he's able to do. And I mean the Way Show as well, if you're not familiar with it. But Lonzo told the people that he got ups, he's dunking. And as you can see, it's not just talking, you know, that's going on with Lonzo Ball. You actually see what's going on the floor. He's taking the necessary steps. You know, when he does take the floor, no matter what team he plays for, because it's to the point now where you can't even really talk about Chicago. You know, you can't talk about some of the pieces that may be there, because he looks like he won't be there. You know, they traded for Josh Giddey. That was one of the first alarms, you know, if you're a Lonzo Ball fan, like, whoa, what's going on? It's kind of ironic that Lonzo was out, you know, and it seemed like they waited till he was about to make his comeback, you know, to bring in a guard who is looking to start, knowing that you have Lonzo there coming off of an injury. If he's 100% healthy, there's no way he's starting. So you immediately, there's no way he's coming off the bench. So you immediately open up a can of worms, you know. So it seems like they're trying to get Lonzo up out of there before, you know, training camp, whatever goes on, because now you got a situation with him and Josh Giddey, you know. And Josh Giddey, with all due respect, a great player, you know, I think he got a tremendous future, but he's not beating out Lonzo. Lonzo is healthy, you know, and then he's upset. So I think to do all of, to cut all this out, they're going to just move Lonzo. You know, number one, Josh Giddey has caused a lot of problems in Chicago. You know, everybody was not happy about this move with Josh Giddey. Clearly, DeMar DeRozan, you know, who was, when Lonzo was there, was the MVP candidate. He was very upset, and dare I say ticked off, confused at why the Chicago Bulls would make a move for Josh Giddey. Not only that, you traded Alex Caruso. Now, I'm pretty sure if you wanted to move Alex Caruso in a reasonable deal, you could have got some equitable value. But clearly, it seems like the Bulls was not thinking about any value here. You know, they clearly just wanted Josh Giddey at all costs. And the way the trade was facilitated, it proved it. And I believe Oklahoma City, they won the trade. You know, whenever you're bringing in an all-NBA defender to your roster out west, it's only going to be beneficial. So, it's crazy. I all I could do is applaud Lonzo, you know, for his
developing, you know, him still out there trying to get on.
People thought his career was over. Oh, he's working on life after basketball and not realizing that basketball is his number one focus. You know, he got hurt, but I want people to remember what he was doing when he got on the floor, when he was on the floor. I don't want to keep sounding like a broken record with the Bulls was the number one seed and all of this, that, and the third, you know, because truth be told, you know, that was true. But I don't know, even if Lonzo was healthy, that they would have held on to the number one seed, you know. I'm not saying they wouldn't have, but I think they would have been definitely a top five seed, you know, whether it was either top three or whatever, I think they would have definitely been in that conversation with the best teams in the East. We got to understand, even when Lonzo was there, they was winning. It was number one. But when they went up against the upper echelon teams, the Bulls struggled. So clearly, when Lonzo was there, they had some things they needed to iron out. But that was a new team. They all were together for a couple of weeks, really, before everybody went down. So I just think the Bulls, I think this whole era with the Bulls was Zach, when they traded for DeMar. Give AK and those guys some props because they tried to do the right thing. You know, who would have fathomed that everything would have just went down like that? I mean, everybody got hurt. Patrick Williams, Lonzo, you know. Then they was in the protocol situation where it was like people was out left and right. You know, even the coach missed time. So I just think that the Bulls, they never got to go. You know, the ultimate goal, at least, we never even got a chance to really see this thing through, you know, and it's very upsetting because we're always going to remember what if they didn't get hurt? How far could have this version of the Bulls went? I think that's something that, you know, we're always going to remember. But I'm not going to get into fits right now, where Lonzo will fit. I'll get into that another time. But I like what I'm seeing from Lonzo. Lonzo has shown that he improved every single year he was in this league. You understand? I expect when we see Lonzo to see another level of improvement. Also, we all know the shot is there. A lot of things that people criticize Lonzo for is going to be beneficial to him when he does get back, you know, until he gets his legs. Because at the end of the day, you could practice with Chris Johnson. You could do all the workouts and stuff. You know, it's no replica for game speed, you know. So Lonzo's got to eventually get out there, you know, get reacclimated to things, and I think he's going to be just fine. You know, I got nothing but confidence in Lonzo. He done been through it all. Look what he's went through already, you know, to get to where he's at now. A lot of people didn't expect what they seen, you know, but I'm going to repeat. Now reiterate and make sure you hear me very clearly, ladies and gentlemen. Lonzo Ball says he should be ready for the start of training camp and the start of the regular season. That is all eyes and antennas is leading there. He also mentioned he has not had any setbacks. So the track is on. You understand? It's going down. Make sure you buckle up and make sure you hit the like button. And most definitely hit the subscribe button. You already know it's Flight Sports TV. We're going to be bringing more Lonzo content. If you're excited, let's get in the comment section and talk.